That's one way I've looked at a more complex mnemonic device in my class. A second way is to look at the method of loci, which is another a pretty common mnemonic device, but it does take more effort. So in this device, one would create what's called a memory palace. So you might use your childhood home, you might use a route you would take to get to work, and you'd identify locations along that route or the rooms in your home in a certain order, and you'd memorize that. You'd work on really making for vivid imagery. What does each room look like and smell like and feel like, and what's in there? And you work on creating that memory palace. The idea then is that when you go to learn a list of ordered items, anytime you need to learn something in life that's ordered, you can mentally go through your memory palace and deposit each item at a time into each location in your memory palace. And it turns out that this is a strategy used by memory champions who compete in the US and the World Memory Championships, who can memorize decks of cards in 30 seconds. It's all variations on this ancient technique. And so the idea then is we have to remember the list of items. You just go back and you walk through your memory palace and you pick up each item along the way. It's known to be very effective. But it takes a lot of work to establish the memory palace. You have to work at using mental imagery, practicing the path before you can deposit items in to use it for remembering lists. In my class, in my human learning and memory class, I have my students create, as an assignment, create a memory palace based on locations on our campus at Goucher College. So they all have this sort of common place that they live, and they create routes. They have to come up with 12 locations in their memory palace, 12 locations on campus in a row. I give them a pretest where they have to recall a grocery list of 12 items with any strategy they want. This is before they know about the memory palace and the method of loci. And so I see how they do on that pretest. Then I teach them about the method of loci. They read the book Moonwalking with Einstein by Joshua Foer, which is all about the memory championships and the kinds of strategies that those memory champions use. And they're given a homework assignment to create that memory palace using locations on their home campus at college. Then they come back after they've created that, and I give them a post-test with a new grocery list, and now they have to remember a new set of items to pick up at the grocery store using their memory palace. And I'm able to then show very convincingly, and they can experience for themselves, how much better their memory gets when using the memory palace, a method of loci. So for the students in the class, they get to actually experience the benefit of using this mnemonic device and seeing that, you know, in their own minds, they've actually demonstrated an improvement. And they can see it in the class results, they can see it individually. And this is one of my ideas that I'm really interested in future research to pursue of, again, translating knowledge of the best strategies to use for learning into actual behavior change and using that strategy more. So to that end, when my students took a survey asking them about all kinds of memory strategies they use, they took it the first week of class and the last week of class. When they do that method of loci assignment in the middle, they do show the biggest improvement in terms of saying they use a strategy from pre to post test in the method of loci and using the memory palace compared to other memory strategies we did not actually demonstrate in class. So I think that's evidence that it really does help students and all of us really to actually have the experience of seeing a memory benefit in yourself from a specific strategy, and I hope that that will support behavior change in the future using these strategies more. Thank you.